Just an early warning had a really unique feeling to it. How do you look back on it?
That was one of the ones that the band probably had the most input into. You know, myself and Neil and the whole band, and Hugh Syme had some input in that. And we did that with David Mallet. And it was very much a collaboration. So we would come up with some of the visual icons to use there. Mm-hmm. And Hugh would put them in some sort of semblance. And David shot the thing and made it look believable. And we saw it as being this big production. And we were very concerned on the quality of cinematography. And he would say to us, look, guys, you know, this is video. Leave it to me. It may not be realistic, but I can promise you at least it'll be surrealistic. And he was absolutely right, and that's the way to make it work. Because in that, you know, it's not like you're filming Superman where you can spend 2 months reshooting. You can't do that. It's all very instant. And he did a great job on it, I think. And I think in terms of impact, that was probably our most successful video.
The plane. There's no swimming in the heavy water, no singing in the acid rain. Red alert, red alert. It's so hard to stay together, passing through revolving doors. We need someone to talk to and someone to sweep the floors.
preparations for the new tour going?
Oh, they're coming. Slowly but surely. I don't think we realized when we were making the record how difficult it would be to play live. Especially my role is, it's really, you know, I'm more of a choreographer this time out than a musician in a lot of ways. So it's going to be tough to pull off, but we will.
Will you put a lot of keyboard parts on tape to deal with that problem?
No, but I'll have a lot of electronic help. I'll have sequencers and sampling machines and a very intricate array of foot pedals that will trigger a whole bunch of different things. And I'm actually going to give Alex a keyboard this time for his side of the stage, because there's a few moments that he's not playing guitar where he can handle the keyboards and I can, you know, play bass and sing. So we're going to sort of share the duties around the stage.
I know you've brought in a keyboard player for the last couple of albums, and I'm wondering, has the discussion ever come up about putting a fourth person on stage?
Yeah, it comes up all the time, but I think we're really afraid to in a lot of ways. You know, there's something about the chemistry and the challenge of doing it that's exciting. At the same time, it's like letting someone else into the club, you know? We're a tight-knit group, the three of us. We have a certain balance. We have a certain relationship. And I think we're afraid to interfere with that too much.
We haven't been on the road.